where the kids have won awards. The clean streets acknowledged in the Lords. But what's a park if you can't see a linnet? A timetable if your journey's infinite. My bag's packed and I'm leaving in a minute. For what is Chatteris without you in it? Car crime's low, the gun crime's lower. The town hall band CD, it's a grower. You never hear of folk getting knocked on the bumps. Although there was a drive-by shouting once. But there's a brass band everywhere. And I don't drive, so I don't care. And as a nightingale sang in Berkeley Square, what's Chatteris if you're not there? Reserve short on pheasants, weavers' cottages devoid of tenants, a market town that lacks quintessence. That's Chatteris without your presence. Three good butchers, two fine chandlers, an indoor pool, and a first class cake shop. Ofsted plaudits, envy of the fens, prick barriers at both ends. But what's Chatteris if you're not there? 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 I may as well be in Ely or St. Ives.
I can recall the day quite clearly. A Friday in July. A sweltering 80 degrees. Martin Jarvis was completing his week in Dictionary Corner. He'd been reassuringly average. Somewhere in the Shires, surgeons had entered the mind of Mr. Stinchcombe and found black apes gibbering on dark lawns. I'd spent the afternoon becoming increasingly frustrated with the grooming agitator on my Lime Dyson. I was due in Parbold at 7:15 and wasn't going to make it. Telephoning the person who needed to know this, I found myself caught up on a crossed line, something I'd not experienced for years. I listened in with quiet delight. It appeared that someone called Bill, whilst out walking the bounds that morning, had looked into Top Acre and been horrified to see the almost visible ribcage of a foal which belonged to the straggle herd girl from Keeper's Cottage, whose name, if this was a Helen Fielding novel, would be something like Martha Flanagan. But the countryside is never as romantic as townsfolk believe it to be, and the girl's name was Karen Henderson. On closer inspection of the poor emaciated beast, it was agreed that a visit upon the child's father was in order. Not a mission to relish, apparently, as the man in question was affected by a strange disquiet which gnawed away at his faith. And it was rumoured his days were spent sucking on the bleached bones of his dead mates whilst writing songs for the hospice. One of which goes like this.
On the bleach bones of my dead mates, trying to get to Parbold for a quarter past seven, and it isn't gonna happen. Hospice, I think you're marvellous. Hospice, I sing your praises. On high days and holidays, I pick you up on high days and holidays. I hear you go on some good outings. I'd like to go on one of your outings. Please take me with you on one of your outings. I heard you going to Billin Aquadrome. I hear you going to Billin Aquadrome. I've never been to Billin Aquadrome. Let me go with you to Billin Aquadrome. Please let me go to Billin Aquadrome. I'll be busking this at embankment. I'll be busking this at embankment. I'll be busking this at embankment tube tomorrow.
January the 6th. Epiphany.